Have you ever faced a folder full of files with different headers, or even headers in different languages? You need them all in one table, with matching headers, but Power Query doesn't make it easy when headers are all over the place. Let's fix that. I'll show you how to set up a quick header mapping solution that will make combining these files super simple. Ready? Let's go! We'll start by importing a mapping table, a simple table with two columns. One column has the original header names and the other has the new names we want to use. But there's one rule to remember. We don't need any rules where the old name and new name are identical. For example, if date is supposed to stay date, we can skip that row. Basically, you can just delete these rows. Or to clean this up, apply a filter in Power Query. Set it so the old name column does not equal the new name column. This way, we are left with only the names that need to be changed. Next, let's transform this mapping table into something we can use to rename the headers. Create a new step and type table to rows with the name of our previous step. This converts our table into a list of lists, where each list contains a pair, the original and new name. This list format is perfect for renaming columns in the next steps. And now it's time to bring in our files. In the queries pane on the left, right-click, select New Query, then choose File and Folder. Find the folder where your files are stored, hit Open and choose Combine and transform data. Select sheet number 1 and press OK. You'll see that the files are combined, but the headers are still all over the place. We'll fix this by applying the header mappings. When combining files in Power Query, the transform sample file step is where we make adjustments to the format. Start by promoting the headers. This turns the first row of each file into the header row, even if they aren't perfect yet. Now it's time to rename the columns. Create a new step and type table rename columns. Then open the brackets. The first argument is our previous step, and the second is our list of name pairs from the mapping table. If you see an error, it's because Power Query ran into a missing header. To handle this, add a third argument, missing field ignore. This tells Power Query to skip headers that don't match, so it doesn't stop with an error. Let's check our main query now. You'll see that all data is combined, the headers are renamed according to the mapping, and columns are in a consistent order. We've got everything lined up. If your files have different numbers of columns, I've got another video that covers that. You can use both methods together for even more control over your files. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe. Bye!